to help us think intuitively about electronic excited states and to write photochemical mechanisms, it's going to be useful to have representations of excited state electron configurations. Let's continue with the carbonyl example, where we saw that the S1 excited state results from the transfer of an electron from a non-bonding level into pi star. A typical way to represent the S1 state of the carbonyl is to use this bracket and star notation, but that doesn't give us a very intuitive way to describe the electron configuration. A better way, a more intuitive way, might be to think about transferring one of the electrons from one of these lone pairs somewhere into pi star. For example, we could move that electron onto carbon. And in doing so, we now have too many electrons around carbon, and so we need to keep pushing electrons around, and we can take the pi electrons and move them onto oxygen. That makes sense because adding electrons into pi star would mean that we're weakening or breaking that pi bond. That leaves us with one example of a way to represent the S1 state of the carbonyl, where we have a diradical character and no pi bond between carbon and oxygen. Consequently, we would expect the carbon-oxygen bond length to increase, and in fact, that's what calculations and experimentation show for the S1 excited state. The changes in the electron configuration, the loss of the pi bond and the rehybridization of carbon, are reflected in the geometry differences between the ground and excited state of formaldehyde as seen here. The sp2 hybridized ground state carbon is planar, and the carbon-oxygen bond is 1.21 angstroms characteristic of a carbon-oxygen double bond. In the excited state, that carbon becomes pyramidal due to the loss of sp2 hybridization, and the carbon-oxygen bond lengthens to 1.32 angstroms, reflective of its single bond character. Another useful way to represent the S1 state is by moving an electron from a non-bonding level into pi star by transferring it to carbon, and then splitting the pi bond by moving one electron onto carbon and one electron back up to oxygen. If you've kept track of everything, you'll realize there's a carbon-oxygen single bond, two lone pairs on oxygen, that means we need a positive formal charge on oxygen, and a lone pair on carbon with a negative charge there. You'll immediately recognize a reversal of polarity for the S1 state. That's a reflection of the large degree of charge transfer to carbon that takes place in exciting the molecule from the ground state to the excited state. The electrostatic potential energy surfaces and corresponding models in this table show the changes in geometry and charge transfer that take place upon going from the S0 state to the first excited state of formaldehyde. From the side view, we can clearly see that the formaldehyde molecule in the ground state is perfectly planar, while in the excited state, there's pyramidalization at carbon. We can see that out-of-plane bending takes place on those hydrogen atoms. From the coloring of the electrostatic potential energy surfaces, where red represents high electron density and blue represents low electron density, in the ground state we can see a lot of electron density around oxygen, whereas there's much less electron density in the first excited state. That's also reflected in the dipole moment magnitude. A much larger dipole moment is present in the ground state compared to the first excited state. Molecular orbital coefficients can help us rationalize the charge reversal that takes place upon promoting an electron from the non-bonding level up to pi star. The LCAO approximation of the non-bonding level is shown here. The largest coefficient is on oxygen. That coefficient is about 0.8. The second largest coefficient is on hydrogen. That's about minus 0.4. Carbon is even smaller. And so when we promote an electron, first from the non-bonding level, it's largely located on oxygen. Promoting it to pi star, here the LCAO approximation and its coefficients have a reversal. Now the largest coefficient is about 0.8 on carbon and minus 0.6 on oxygen. And so now the electron in the pi star is largely located on that carbon atom. The most important consequence of the redistribution of electrons in the first excited state is the role reversal of the molecular orbitals that are involved in the chemistry. In the ground state, the highest occupied molecular orbital was nucleophilic, but because it's now singly occupied, a singly occupied molecular orbital, that vacancy becomes electrophilic. And while the pi star level was electrophilic in the ground state, it becomes nucleophilic, that singly occupied molecular orbital of the S1 excited state becomes nucleophilic. We'll see more about this in upcoming webcasts.